Hello, my name is Katie Moore, and I'm a meteorologist with the National Weather Service Office in Tallahassee, Florida. This briefing on Monday, July 1st, 2013, is about the potential for heavy rainfall and flooding in our forecast area through Thursday. Water vapor imagery from this morning shows a plume of moisture feeding from the Gulf of Mexico northeastward over the southeastern United States. This moisture is being driven by an anomalously deep trough of low pressure over the eastern United States. The image shown demonstrates that this low pressure is as much as 3 standard deviations below what is normal for this time of year. The trough will retrograde, or shift westward through the week. As the low moves westward, higher pressure over the Atlantic coast will shift westward as well, creating a stream of moisture from the Gulf of Mexico northwestward into our forecast area. The Weather Prediction Center, or WPC, Day 1 through 3 Quantitative Precipitation Forecast, or QPF, shows widespread areas of 2 to 4 inches of rain across the region today through Wednesday night. The WPC Day 4 through 5 QPF shows an additional 1 to 2 inches may fall over the western part of our forecast area Thursday and Friday. The majority of the rain in our area is expected to fall between Wednesday night and Thursday, the 4th of July. So if you have any outdoor plans for the 4th of July, consider making alternative indoor plans. Our local forecast calls for rainfall accumulations of 2 to 4 inches across the tri-state area from today, Monday, July 1st, 2013, through Thursday, July 4th, 2013. Locally, higher rainfall amounts are likely in areas where storms are slower moving. It is possible that some areas may receive 6 to 8 inches of rain. We have high confidence in our forecast for a rainy week, with much of the area receiving 2 to 4 inches of rain, and most of the rain falling Wednesday night through Thursday. We have lower confidence in where the rainfall amounts will be highest. Heavy rainfall may cause flooding in urban and/or low-lying areas, especially where rainfall has accumulated through the period. Remember, if you see pooling of water on the road, don't drive into it. It can be hard to judge how deep the water really is and how fast it is moving, and you can lose control of your vehicle. Turn around, don't drown.